tonight's game between the Emmanuel College Lions and your North Greenville Crusaders. As always, Crusader basketball games can be watched live online. The link can be found at ngcrusaders.com. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the invocation of our men standing as John America with the playing of our national anthem. Dear Lord, thank you for the game of basketball. Thank you for both teams represented here tonight and the abilities that you bless each individual with. I pray that you be honored with the conduct of both teams and the outcome of tonight's game. We love you and thank you for your eternal love and mercy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
About set for game number two here from Hayes Gymnasium on the eve of Thanksgiving break for North Greenville University students. It's the men's turn as North Greenville once again faces Emmanuel College. North Greenville liking to go with gray jerseys with red trimmings. Emmanuel in their maroon jerseys. North Greenville wins the opening tip, controlled by number 31, Spencer Reeves. Reeves heads to the near side, now cuts it back up top. Backs off from the pressure, passes right to number 32, LaShawn Alexander, who in turn passes off to number 3, tries for a shot, high off the numbers is Carville McElroy. And That'll be a turnover back to the Lions. Now controlled by number 33, Michael Stanley. Now to the left side, Jeremy Burgess in control. Passing back to Luke Miller. Now back to Burgess on the left side of key. Burgess drives the basket. Backs out. Looks for somebody to pass to. Heavy defense on him. Finally gets a pass to Burgess. And now that's number 33 losing the ball. Stanley tried a shot. Stripped away by Alexander for North Greenville. Now number two, McElroy passing left side. Parker, Micah Parker passes back up top of the key. Has Alexander. Alexander heads right to Reeves. Now to Phillip Brown. Brown heads back left to Parker. Parker trying to find some space, nothing doing. 10 approaching 10 on the shot clock. He'll hand off to Alexander. Alexander trying to find Brown underneath. Brown turns, puts up a shot. It goes in, good, with 5 on the shot clock. North Greenville strikes first, 2-0. Now number 33, Stanley, hands off to Matt McCrary. Now left side and Burgess trying to go underneath. Number 21, McCrary puts up a shot over Brown and gets it in. And we are tied at 2. Now McElroy heads right side. Double teamed and tries to get a pass to number 32. That is Alexander picking it up, handing off to Parker. Parker is blocked out of bounds by Zach Lilly. It remains North Greenville ball, however. Lilly blocked it out of bounds. Reeves inbounds and poked away, but Alexander gathers it back, right side of the key, looking for help, passes cross court to Parker. Parker one-on-one, tries to get a shot, can't get the shot, but he will draw the foul. And our first foul of the game will go against Emmanuel. That'll be on number 22, Zach Lilly, his first. Micah Parker. Senior out of Woodbridge, Virginia. At the free throw line, his first shot. In and good. Second shot is short, off the front of the rim, no good. Rebounded by Burgess for the Lions. Now heading back from left to right. Fires a pass, gets it to number 23. Now Miller has it stripped, gathers it back, gets it back to Burgess right side of the key. Goes underneath to McCrary. McCrary trying to find room to the basket, has to pass back to Miller. Now far side corner for three. Burgess misses a three. Another offensive rebound by McCrary for the Lions. Now a three from Stanley is good. Emmanuel 5-3, 2-point advantage. McElroy in control for the Crusaders. Heads to the right side of the key. Into the far side corner, drives to the basket. Blocked out of bounds. And a little stake Crusader ball. It was reamed back in by Reeves. And he will go back for the inbound. Reeves lobs it up. Alexander brings it down. Passes off to Parker. Parker, right side of the key, cuts it back to the middle. Hands off to Alexander, gets a shot in. All knotted back up at 5. Stanley heads right side, passes off to McCrary. Now back to the left side in Burgess. Burgess finds Miller. Miller trying to spin his way down the middle, passes back out to Burgess. On the left side of the key, and I'll find Stanley again. Stanley heads to the right side, passes inside to Burgess. Burgess drives, double teamed, fires a sideways pass to McCrary. Now to Lilly. Now it's 4 on the shot clock. Behind the back shot from Patrick McCrary goes in. 7-5. Lions back out front by 2. Alexander, right side, lobs it underneath for Reeves. Reeves spits it out to McElroy. 3 from Parker is no good. And battle for the rebound is brought down by Miller for the Lions. Now Miller hands off to number 33, Stanley. Stanley fires to Burgess, left side of the key. Burgess fakes the handoff, spins underneath, puts a jump shot in, no good, and rebounded by Alexander. LaShawn Alexander passes forward to McElroy, and Brown gets a tough shot to go in, and we're tied back up at 7. Now Stanley, passing right, has McCrary. McCrary, cross court to Burgess. Burgess, left side of the key, underneath to McCrary. McCrary, defense provided by Brown, fires to Burgess. Burgess in the near side corner will bring it out. Passes to Stanley. Stanley, top of the key, is going to fire a three from there. Long to no good. And rebounded by Brown. Now McElroy, driving underneath, puts up a shot, gets it in. North Greenville out front, 9-7. Stanley passes left to Burgess. Burgess on the left side of the key for the Lions. Finds Stanley. Stanley still on the left side. Trying to cut it down the middle. Passes out to Burgess. Burgess near side for three. Wide open, and he drains it.
North Greenville is daring him to shoot that three, and they paid for it.
Next dead ball will be the first media timeout. McElroy fires to Brown on the far side. Brown has to go back to McElroy. McElroy, top of the key, looking for assistance, moving right, passes left to Parker. Parker drives down the middle, runs into a couple players, can't get the shot to go. Rebounded by Lilly, hands off to Miller. Miller, top of the key, juking and jiving his way in, and blocked out of bounds by Alexander. And first media timeout of the first half, 14:06 left to go. Between North Greenville and Emmanuel, North Greenville is down 1-10-9 here in the men's contest on the Crusader Sports Network. Greenville down 1-10-9, opening minutes here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
It's worth mentioning, Emmanuel comes into this game 1-3.
Emmanuel has control of the basketball.
While North Greenville is 1-2 for the season.
And Brown blocks number 21, McCrary. Now North Greenville loses the basketball and is picked up by McCrary heading the other way. And he hands off to Stanley. Stanley blocked by Brown, catches his own rebound, trying to tip it in finally. Yeah, number 14, Zach Vess, pushes the Lions out by 3, 12-9. Now Reeves has his pass tipped to Brown. Brown brings it down, hits the basket, puts up a shot and gets it in. 12-11, Crusaders still down one. Stanley passing off right side to McCrary. Now back to Vess, top of the key, right, left side to Burgess. Now number 10, Steve Gouchard. Now Burgess, now Stanley top of the key, has to go right back to Gouchard. Gouchard, Burgess, right side. Brings it back up top. Still looking left, passes underneath to Vess. Vess drives to the basket. Brown on defense. Vess puts up a shot and has it blocked by Brown. I believe we had a foul called as well. It will stay with Emmanuel. Stanley looking for the inbound. Finds Burgess. Jump shot. No good. Rebounded by number 13 for North Greenville. That was Troy Blyden. Had a tough time keeping it in bounds. And now the first team foul for North Greenville goes up on the scoreboard. And they get Blyden for his first. And Patrick McCrary was the one who was fouled. He'll head to the free throw line. McCrary's first shot is good. Second shot is also good, taking his time on that one. 14 to 11, North Greenville down three. Full court pressed by Emmanuel. Blyden in control, one-on-one, dishes out to Reeves for three from the far side, he's got it. Knotted up at 14. Now Stanley has to go right side to McCrary. Now left side of the key, Burgess in control. Burgess looking for some assistance. Goes underneath to McCrary. McCrary spinning for the basket, puts up a shot, and it goes in. North Greenville looking for quick answers. Michael Parker down the far side. Dishes out to Reeves and gets it in for a quick two. Stanley dishes off to McCrary. McCrary back up top to Vest. Now left side and Burgess again. Left side of the key, Burgess back up top too. Dwayne Shard. Burgess top of the key for the Lions. Tries to dish underneath, finds Vest. Vest spinning, looking for some help. One-on-one with Blyden. Passes back out to Gunshard. Now left side of the key and Burgess. Five on the shot clock. Burgess puts up a shot and it's no good. Brown rebounds for North Greenville. And Brown will hand off to McElroy. McElroy down the far court side quickly, right through the defense and can't get a shot to go. And it's rebounded by Stanley. Stanley, two-on-two situation. Stanley tries a shot and he'll go out of bounds and he'll stay with the Lions. Christian Davis checks in for the Crusaders. Emmanuel in control. Stanley right side of the key. Davis on the defense. Stanley moves right. One-on-one with Davis. Passes to number three, Miller. Miller trying to drive down the middle. Hands off to Stanley near side. Fakes a three. Tries to drive in again. Dishes out again to Miller. He'll fire a three, and it goes in good. 19-16. Davis passes right to Ja Jinks. Now in the ball game for North Greenville. Jinks heads left side. Reeves for three. Can't get the three, but he is fouled by the other number three, Luke Miller, for Emmanuel. And he was fouled outside the three-point arc, so he should get three shots. Number 31, Spencer Reeves to the free throw line. Only three team fouls total for both teams, and we're almost halfway through the first half. First shot from Reeves is good.
Reeves is now 6-for-8 for the season in free throws.
Second shot also good. One more. The third shot is also good. 3-for-3 that run, and we're tied up at 19.
Now, 8 out of 10 for the season.
Stanley in control for the Lions. Hands off to Gunshard. Now left side to Miller. Miller fires back to Gunchard. He'll fire a three, and it's no good. And North Greenville ball off the turnover. Davis fires left side of the key, has Parker. Parker looking for some space down the middle, goes to Davis from far side for three, it no good. Tipped up and rebounded by Vess for the Lions. Now quickly down, Stanley, left side of the key. For the Lions, hands off to Miller. Miller driving underneath, nothing doing, passes back out to Stanley. Stanley fires underneath to Vess. Vess dishes it out to Miller, near side three is no good, off the rim. Battle for the rebound, Stanley gets it back. Puts it up for two and in, good. 21-19, Lions up by two. Davis now. Right side of the key has number 23, that is Chris Brown. Now trying to go underneath to Jinx, knocked away by a Lions defender. And top of the key for the Lions. Now left side, Miller. Trying to find Stanley, goes underneath to Terrence Polk. Polk fires back out to Gunchard for three. It is no good and loses a rebound. And a foul will be called against Emmanuel. And three team fouls on the board for Emmanuel. That one called against number 14, Zach Vess. And to the second media timeout we go. 9:19 left to go in the ballgame. North Greenville down 2, 21-19 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Left to go in the first half here between North Greenville and Emmanuel. It's the men's turn. North Greenville, a little bit of work to do, down 2, 21-19. They will have the ball after the Emmanuel foul. Davis to Brown. Brown left side and McElroy. McElroy, top of the key, fires left to Brown. Brown's going to fire three and he's got it. 22-21, Philip Brown puts the Crusaders back out in front. Now it's Emmanuel's turn. Miller, left side of the key, goes underneath to Vess. Vess puts up a shot, blocked out of bounds by Brown. Brown definitely one of the leading blockers for this Crusader team. Number 15, Wyatt Sippy, checking into the ball game, as well as Patrick McCrary back in for the Lions. And Terrence Polk receives the inbound. Passes to Miller for three, no good. Battle for the rebound, and it is lost out of bounds by Chris Brown for North Greenville. So Lions get it right back.
You know, we were talking about the women's team getting a lot of offensive rebounds, and it looks like Emmanuel's men's team is doing the same. Six offensive rebounds to North Greenville's two.
Miller trying to go underneath to McCrary. McCrary driving into the paint, passes back out to number 11. That is Jonathan Penarat. Now has to pass back out to McCrary. McCrary fires a deep two, no good. And rebounded by McElroy. McElroy in control for North Greenville, heads to the right side. Now drives underneath. Pass is knocked away by Emmanuel. And Miller heading down 2-on-1, and he somehow almost got it in. And the foul called underneath. Number 21, Patrick McCrary, went down. Two team fouls on North Greenville. Phillip Brown picking up his first and sends McCrary to the free throw line. McCrary's first shot is any good. Tied at 22. Second shot is also good, ramming in. Emmanuel back out front, 23-22. Davis down the far court side for North Greenville. Passes right to McElroy. McElroy finds some space. Passes cross court to number 23, Brown for three, no good. Rebounded by McElroy for the Lions. Now quickly forward to Miller. Miller, top of the key, dishes right, has Sippy. Sippy passes right to McCrary again. McCrary near side corner. Has it knocked away by number 32, LaShawn Alexander. It's picked up by Alexander. Passes to McElroy. McElroy, Davis, back to McElroy. Brown for three from the top of the key. It's out, in and out, no good. And rebounded by Miller for the Lions. Passes off to Sippy. Davis, heavy defense on him. Somehow spins out of it, passes down the court. Finds Jonathan Pinnerat. And now Pinnerat, far side corner. Passes underneath to Sippy, who will be called for an offensive foul. I
believe that was a travel there.
It's on the offense and illegal to do a basketball, so offensive and sort of a foul.
It's a travel.
Travel.
Great. Travel.
Yeah. Back to North Greenville, down one. Davis, left side of the key, going underneath quickly to Alexander for two, no good. And it is McElroy going down hard on the court floor, who got the rebound for North Greenville. He also got fouled, so he will head to the free throw line. Actually, correction, North Greenville just retains possession of the ball. That last foul on Luke Miller, number three, his second. Davis looking for the inbound. Still looking. Lobs it up for Brown. Brown brings it down top of the key. Passes left to McElroy. McElroy left side of the key. Backing out of the pressure. Now moving right. Passes back left to Brown. Brown lines up a three, instead passes underneath to Alexander. Alexander spins out of the pressure, has it popped up and blocked. And it's brought down by Lilly for the Lions, who passes off to Sippy. Now left side, now back right side to Stanley. Stanley lining up threes on the far side, not taking any, passing underneath to McCrary. McCrary now back left side to Sippy. Sippy tries to drive underneath. Lines a shot underneath to number 22, Lilly. Passes back now near side. Miller again for three. So make that Sippy. And now finally underneath for two was Terrence Polk, who gets the Lions back out in front by three, 25-22. Brown top of the key, moves right. Loses the ball, gets it back. Now passes to McElroy left side. McElroy brings it back up top. Now he'll move right. 15 on the shot clock for him. Passes to Brown. Brown trying to drive to the middle. Passes back out to McElroy. McElroy, near side corner. Davis underneath quickly to Alexander for 2 points, and he's got it. 25-24. Crusaders have been one again. Now right side, McCrary has to go all the way to the left side to Holt. Now Stanley, right side, Sippy. Top of the key, Nothing doing, passing back right to Stanley. Now quickly underneath to number 22, that is Lily. Tries to get a shot to go in, can't do it, and scramble for the rebound on the court floor. And it will go to North Greenville.
Well, Emmanuel has possession right now. That was a jump ball, wasn't it? So, yeah, I think Emmanuel gets the ball, but a timeout's called.
Good call by Coach Chad Lister for North Greenville University. 5:02, one more media timeout standing between us and the halftime break.
Talk about a few statistics real quick. North Greenville 50% in field goals, 9 for 18. Emmanuel 33.3%, 9 out of 27.
And it looks like North Greenville will get possession.
Okay, so I was wrong. Excuse me there, Gray.
Underneath the Brown from Chris Brown. Phillip Brown can't get the shot to go in. Now Emmanuel. Passing forward to Stanley. Stanley gets a quick two in off the pass from Willie McCassin. Now back right side. Micah Parker, right side of the key, looking for some space. Backs out. Now passes top of the key, has a Sean Alexander. Back left side to Chris Brown. The call will go against North Greenville's. Time is stopped. They get LaShawn Alexander for his first foul. And third and final media timeout of the first half. 4:23 left to go. North Greenville down 3, 27 to 24. With possession, 4:20 left to go until halftime. Left side of the key. And a dunk is missed by Zach Lilly. A little bit of a lob pass, a little too high for him. North Greenville gets a rebound. Rebound heading the other way. Spencer Reeves back in for North Greenville. Has his pass mishandled by Micah Parker, so right back to the Lions yet again.
That's been a little bit of a struggle here for North Greenville, their seventh turnover of the game. Emmanuel's been able to keep it pretty clean, just two for them.
Sippy passing right side, has Stanley. Stanley goes back cross court. Now Sippy trying to go underneath, has McCrary. McCrary makes a drive for the basket. Brown blocks him. Stanley left side of the key. Looking for room, spins out, passes to Sippy. Now top of the key has McCassin. Now trying to go underneath to Lilly. Lilly loses it momentarily. Passes Stanley, right side for three, no good. And Brown gets it down for North Greenville. Now Reeves goes deep, has Alexander. Alexander gets it in. Marka Parker passes right side. And for three is good from Chris Brown. Game tied at 27. Now Stanley spinning his way, trying to spin his way underneath. Passes back out to McCrary. Now that'll be number 25, Akasson lining up for three and missing. North Greenville brings it back down. Reeves right side of the key, looking for space. Stanley on defense for the Lions. Reeves passing left side to Parker. Parker left side of the key. Brings it back up top, passes to Brown. Brown back to the right side, and Brown, Chris Brown. Brown's gonna line it up for three. Phillip Brown then gets it off the glass to go. Phillip Brown for three, 30-27, North Greenville out front. Now Stanley, left side, has a Casson. Casson hands off to Sippy, left side of the key, now back Stanley up top. Stanley goes right side to McCasson again. Now back to Sippy, top of the key, back left side, Stanley. Stanley lined up for three from the far side, no good. Brown rebounds again. Now he'll fire deep for Alexander. Alexander 1-on-1, easy two is good. Yeah. 32-27, North Greenville up by five, 2 minutes to play. McCasson, Sippy. Now Stanley. Stanley driving underneath and a host of Crusaders and somehow gets it in.
What a shot.
Four Crusaders all around him and he still gets it to go. Under 2 minutes to play until halftime. North Greenville up 32-29. Reeves driving left side. Stanley on defense. Passes off to Alexander and pass is lost momentarily. That is Chris Brown getting for two. They'll have a chance for one more. Chris Brown at the free throw line for North Greenville. That last foul on Wyatt Sippy, number 15, his first. First free throw, the free throw is in and out. So only 2 points that go around. It's now Stanley drives underneath, puts up a shot. Brown misses the block. And Emmanuel 34-31. Still down three for the Lions. Corval McRoy in front court. Stanley again on the defense, passing right side to Reeves. Reeves back to McRoy. McRoy looking for a way around Stanley. McRoy heads to the right side, still heading that way, driving underneath, passing out to Alexander for two, no good, tipped up, still battling for it. Reeves keeps it in bounds, and he loses it out of bounds, and the near side official will also think he signaled a foul. A foul up on the scoreboard, but it will be Emmanuel's ball coming out of the timeout with a minute left. North Greenville up 34-31. Quick timeout by Emmanuel. They will have the ball. 51.2 seconds left until halftime. And now Stanley hands off to number 10, Stephen Guinchard. Guinchard, right side of the key, goes underneath, has McCrary. McCrary fires over Brown and no good. Reeves brings it down to North Greenville. Shot clock now turned off. 30 seconds to go till halftime. Greenville up three. McElroy taking his time, working his way around Stanley, passing to Parker. Parker on the right side of the key, 18 seconds. Parker looking for a way around. Dishes out to Brown. Brown back to Reeves, now firing back out to McElroy. 8 seconds left. McElroy pushes left, drives underneath, dishes to Alexander for a quick two, and has it. And now 2 seconds, Emmanuel trying to get it in bounds, and the clock will run out on him. And to halftime we go, 36-31. North Greenville up five here in the halftime of the second game of this doubleheader on the North Greenville Sports Network.
As we return, just about set for the second half to begin. I believe that Emmanuel has possession, so they will get the ball to start. Trying to go over some quick team stats. North Greenville, 56% in field goal percentage, 14 out of 25. And then Emmanuel, 12 for 35 with a 34.3 field goal percentage. And unfortunately, that's all we're going to have time for, Gray.
Emmanuel, back in control to start the second half. And already a shot and a foul from Jeremy Burgess. So 9 seconds in, North Greenville's already got a team foul on the board. It's on Micah Parker, his first. And at the free throw line is Jeremy Burgess.
Yeah, we know we sound a little disorganized right now with the stats. We usually have statistic screens as that first free throw is missed. We usually have statistic graphics, but unfortunately for basketball, those are not yet ready. So we'll get to work on those during the Thanksgiving break, and hopefully we'll have them ready by the next game.
Both free throws missed by Burgess, and North Greenville quick on the rebound. Corville McElroy in control for the Crusaders. Passing underneath to Brown, Phillip Brown. Trying to work his way inside, puts up the shot, one-handed, misses, and it is rebounded by Luke Miller. Miller now in control as number 31, Spencer Reeves, all over him. Miller passes off to Stanley to avoid any further pressure from Reeves. And a tie-up on the basketball. Jump ball is the call, and that is North Greenville's possession arrow. McElroy into front court, passing right to Reeves. Reeves looking for help and trying to work his way underneath, passing to Phillip Brown. Phillip Brown, long two is no good, and rebounded by number 33, Stanley. Stanley got the foul, but he didn't, I'm not sure that he wanted one. He was trying to get away in a hurry.
That was called a little late. There was some contact on that play. So we're looking at the instant replay there. So two fouls already for North Greenville. Still very early in the second half.
Both of them on Micah Parker, number three, already up to two. Emmanuel in the hands of Patrick McCrary. Hands off to Zach Lilly. Now lob shot. Lilly knocks it back and bounce. Stanley for three is no good, rimming out. And they'll stay Emmanuel ball as Phillip Brown blocked it out. Stay Lions basketball. Brown might have banged up his ankle a little bit.
Trying to walk it off in some, obviously in pain.
Brown injured late in the season last year.
Yes, he's.
Or last season.
Yeah, he's going to go into the locker room, so let's hope that that's not too serious.
Number 33, Ja Jinks, in the place of the injured Phillip Brown, will take his place. And Emmanuel trying to get shots off to finally get one in and close within three. McElroy down the far court side. Left side of the key, cuts it back up top, slings it underneath to Jinks, who bobbles it. And Emmanuel keeps it in bounds. Now Burgess, near side of the key. Stanley passes back out to Burgess. Burgess has to pass back out to Miller. Miller still on the right side, looking for room. And North Greenville will get the ball on the Emmanuel turnover. North Greenville back in control of the basketball, up three. McElroy quickly underneath Alexander. Alexander has his pass tipped. McElroy brings it down. Now to Reeves, three, top of the key, it's good! Did that shot as he was falling down. 39-33. McCrary passing all the way around the bird. It's quickly underneath to McCrary again. And we have a foul whistled. Three, all three in the second half on North Greenville. That one on 31, number 31, Spencer Reeves picks up his first. As it is Lilly handing off to Stanley. Stanley, left side of the key, trying to go underneath to Miller. Loses it, gathers it back, gets it to Burgess now, trying to go underneath to Lilly. Lilly has to pass back up and has it stolen by McElroy. McElroy into open court and is going to jam it home. 41-33, North Greenville up. Stanley, right side of the key, again for the Lions, trying to get some offensive juice back going. Miller will fire for three, it's no good. And North Greenville keeps it in bounds. That's a one-handed jam from Zach Lilly. 41-35, trying to keep Emmanuel within single digits. McElroy, front court for North Greenville, passes right to Parker. Parker cross court again to McElroy, now on the left side of the key, underneath to Jinks. Jinks spinning for the basket, puts up a shot and in, good. 43-35. Now Stanley quickly the other way for the Lions. Passes behind them to McCrary. Now left side of the key and Burgess. Burgess back to top of the key and Miller. Miller, free throw line jumper is no good and rebounded by Alexander. Alexander quickly to McElroy, now quickly to Jinks and can't bring it down.
Number
Turnover back to the Lions. Number 14, Zach Vest checks back in for the Lions. Stanley passes left to Burgess. Burgess back Vest, top of the key. Now back right. Has McCrary. Now far side corner and Stanley. Stanley drove in, backed out. Now passes to Burgess, still on the right side. Burgess will try the same thing. Spins for the basket, puts it up and in. Good. 43-37. Christian Davis for the Crusaders in the front court. Passes left and has it tipped out of bounds by Burgess, Jeremy Burgess. On the deflection, it'll stay Crusader basketball. Micah Parker set to inbound. Parker finds Reeves, who is fouled right away. And the first team foul to have for Emmanuel. That one goes on Luke Miller, who picks up his third. Almost 5 minutes into this second half. Winchard checking back in for the Lions. North Greenville trying to find the inbound. Lobs it up to Alexander, and he is fouled before the shot attempt. It's now two team fouls in a row against Emmanuel. And they get Zach Vest for his second. Quickly inbounded again for the Crusaders, and another quick foul.
So we're talking about how Emmanuel had no fouls, and within what, the last 15 or 20 seconds, they all of a sudden have three.
And they get number 33, Michael Stanley, for his first. And North Greenville gets the inbound cleanly this time. Blyden, top of the key, passes right to Reeves. Reeves, right side of the key, cuts it back up top. Now heads to the left side, looks for some help. Drives underneath, passes out to Parker. Parker drives underneath, puts it up and in, good. 45-37. North Greenville is up eight. Now, left side corner, Jeremy Burgess for the Lions. He'll bring it back up top, passing to Winchard. Winchard passes to Stanley. Stanley tries a shot, no good. Put back, also no good by Vest. And Emmanuel has to chase it back down, pushing and shoving, going on. No foul called. Stanley back in control. Top of the key, passes left to Burgess. He'll line up a three, and it's good.
Obviously, Emmanuel needed that one. They had not scored some points in a little while, so that was a big block there.
Micah Parker tried to line up his own three, and he was quickly blocked by Jeremy Burgess, who got there in a hurry. And first media timeout of the second half, 14:45 left to go in the second half until the end of regulation in this one. 45-40, North Greenville is up five. Greenville in control of the basketball. Spencer Reeves set for the inbound, trying to find somebody, finds Parker. Parker goes all the way back to Christian Davis, just barely in the front court. Davis looks for some help, has his pass knocked away. Alexander brings it back. Now fires to Parker in the near side corner. Parker drives underneath, has a shot blocked, gathers it back. Still on the right side of the key, goes underneath Alexander, swarmed immediately. And now Reeves fires a three and he's got it. North Greenville up eight again. Now Manuel, top of the key, invests. Passes left to Burgess. Burgess brings it back to the top, passes right to Stanley. Stanley trying to go underneath. He has McCreary. McCreary drives to the basket, puts up a shot, and it rolls out. Battle for the rebound is brought down by Blyden for North Greenville. Quickly goes to Davis. Davis into front court, passes right to Reeves. Now into the corner, and Parker. Parker drives to the basket and has his pass knocked away. Now right to Blyden, blocked again, and Stanley comes down with it for the Lions. Stanley heading down the right side, loses it to Davis. And it's going to be a foul against North Greenville on that rush. And they get Christian Davis for his first foul. Also, briefly, we saw Phillip Brown come back out and put on his warm-up jersey and head back to the locker room. So it looks like he might be done for the rest of this game. Stanley passing to Gwynshard. Gwynshard. Right side of the key, looking for help. Goes to McCreary. McCreary fires it out to Burgess. Now Stanley, left side. Stanley, left side of the key. Reeves on defense for North Greenville. Burgess, right side of the key. Drives underneath, swarmed immediately. Stanley, easy twos, got it for that layup. 48-42, North Greenville up six. Davis lobs a pass, gets it to Alexander. Alexander goes back to Blyden. Blyden heads to the right side of the key, passes to Davis, who is there. Davis back to the top of the key and Reeves. He's going to drop another three. It misses it. And it's rebounded by Stanley. Now Stanley heads to the right side, drives down the middle, puts it up and no good. And he will get a foul as well. Five team fouls now for North Greenville. And they will catch. Looks like they'll get LaShawn Alexander, number 32, for his second. And now here comes Phillip Brown. And Phillip Brown is back in the game. Wasn't quite sure what would happen to Brown. Limped off the court in obvious pain. Obviously, that has been fixed as the first shot is good from Stanley. And it is good to see Phillip Brown back out there. Definitely one of the leading blockers for this team. You can't deny that. And 6'7", underneath the basket, he's going to be a threat for every point he can get. Yeah,
he's a big presence, that's for sure.
Michael Stanley trying to get the Lions back with him four, and he will do so. 48-44. McElroy in the front court for North Greenville. Passes to Phillip Brown. Left side of the key. Brown drives right, hands off to Reeves. Reeves, near side, looks for help. Double team, spins out of it. Passes to Parker. Far side corner for three, and it's good. 51-44, North Greenville up. Stanley right side. Hands off to McCreary, now to Gwynshard. Stanley again, driving, puts up a shot, gets it off the glass and in, good. 51-46. That's now McElroy. Front court again for North Greenville. Stanley on the defense for the Lions. Looks left, looks right. Now Stanley gets in his face and he hands off to Brown, who gets back McElroy. Michael Parker, far side corner, looking to get around. The defender passes out to Christian, make that Reeves. Reeves fires a free throw line. Jumper is good for two. 53-46. Stanley, quickly, right down the middle. Puts up a shot over Phillip Brown. Can't get it to go in. Lions get the rebound. Scramble for it right underneath the basket. And Emmanuel loses it out of bounds off of a North Greenville player's foot. And so it'll stay Lions ball. Stanley looking for the inbound. finds number 25 for two. That is Willie Nakasa. 53-48. Emmanuel trying to stay in the ball game. McElroy, right side double team, passes off to Phillip Brown. Now to Parker on the left side. Parker drives underneath and will draw a foul underneath the basket. Put 14 fouls up on the board for Emmanuel, and they will also catch Zach Vest for his third. And the lob inbound to Phillip Brown. Brown passes right to Parker. Michael Parker, bring it back up top, passes to McElroy. Stanley on the defense. McElroy passes back to Parker on the left side of the key now. Spins back to McElroy. McElroy, far side corner, driving underneath. Behind his back, and that one goes in for two, and he'll have a chance for one more. $15,000 apiece now for either team, and that one is on the Lions. Number 20, Terrence Polk is first. Chance for one more here from McElroy. Yeah, shot is up and rattles in good, 56-48. And number 23, Chris Brown. For North Greenville, checks back in. Stanley passes right to number 20, that's Polk. Now left side, Akasson brings it back up top. Passing right to Stanley. Stanley trying to drive underneath, loses it, and North Greenville comes down with it for the moment. Stanley battles for it, and that is number 20, Terrence Polk, coming down with it at last for the Lions. Winchard hands back to Stanley. He'll line up a three from the near side. It is no good. And Parker goes down hard, but he has the basketball for NGU. And Parker looks to be okay from that. Went down a little hard on that left elbow. He's okay. North Greenville get the basketball. Spencer Reeves needs to get in the front court for North Greenville, and he finally does not. Officials have to have a discussion about that. And it's a manual ball. Backcourt violation in effect. Coach Lister not quite ready. Trying to understand that last call.
With the break in the action, we'll go over some more statistics real quick for field goals. North Greenville now 21 for 38. That's a 55.3 field goal percentage. Emmanuel 19 for 50. That's a 38 percentage.
Tough shooting tonight for the Lions. They try to get more points here, under 10 to play. Stanley to Burgess on the right side of the key. Back up top, has McCreary. McCreary drives in, now backs out, now back to Burgess. Now to number 11, John Pinnerat. And Polk. Polk now drives, puts up a shot, and can't get it to go in. He will get a foul off of North Greenville. Bring it up to $16,000 apiece, and Deshaun Alexander brings his third personal foul up on the scoreboard as well. So to the second media timeout, 9:40 left. North Greenville up 56-48. So far taking care of business here from Hayes Gymnasium.
Yeah.
Free throw is upcoming for the Emmanuel Lions from number 20, Terrence Polk. First shot from him is too high, no good. One more from Polk. It is short, no good. And the battle for the rebound is brought down by Spencer Rees for NGU. Now McElroy gets it in the front court, passes to Phillip Brown, left side of the key. Brown has to pass back to McElroy. And McElroy goes to Parker, cross court to Rees. Rees, right side of the key, passes to McElroy. McElroy back to Reeves, now underneath Alexander. Double team, trying to spin out of it, takes a shot, misses. Parker on the rebound, actually McElroy on the rebound. Now passes to Parker, now back to McElroy. Shot clock is reset, new 30 seconds. McElroy has a pass deflected, and Parker scoops it from going in bounds. Now Phillip Brown, left side of the key, goes to Parker. Now to Reeves, right side of the key. Reeves trying to find some help, spins out of it, finds Parker, top of the key. Trying to do something, passing to McElroy left side. Brown drives to the basket, puts up a shot and can't get it in. But Brown will draw the foul. As number 20, Terrence Polk draws his third personal. Philip Brown heads to the free throw line for a couple.
Philip Brown 6 for 10 this season in free throws.
And can't get that one to go. Winshard and Burgess check back in for the Lions. Brown's second shot, also short, rebounded by McCrary. Stanley, top of the key for the Lions, passes right to Winshard, who finds Miller. Miller back to Burgess up top, now back right side to Stanley. Stanley passes right, again has McCrary there. McCrary brings it back up top, hands off to Winshard. Now Burgess on the right side. Now Miller trying to make a drive underneath, loses a shot out of bounds off of Spencer Rees. It'll stay Lions ball with 9 on the shot clock. Stanley looking for the inbound, who finds McCrary. McCrary has 5 on the shot clock, makes a drive. So he called for a double dribble. Yep. Turnover back to North Greenville.
Sort of stuck in the corner of the court there, and with the shot clock winding down, just did what he could, but unfortunately for him, couldn't get away with it.
Now Reeves trying to find an inbound of his own. And North Greenville gets a timeout called just in time for the inbound. 5-second rule expires. 8:13 left. North Greenville calls timeout to get their strategy straight. 56-48 is the advantage for North Greenville. Thank you. North Greenville will send Phillip Brown back to inbound, see if he can try and get this one in. And Brown's going to heave it deep for Parker, and it's picked off by McCrary. Now Lions with an offensive turnaround, trying to get something going. Burgess top of the key for the Lions. Bit of a flip back pass with McCrary there. Now Miller right side of the key, back to McCrary. McCrary at the free throw line, passes to Stanley. Stanley juking and driving, puts it in for two, good. Phillip Brown back to inbound. And Alexander brings it. Now he'll heave it deep for Parker. Parker for two has it blocked. That's still a live ball. And finally, a foul is called and North Greenville will retain the ball.
Yeah, he hit that those pads pretty hard there. Good to see him get up.
That'd be Michael Parker, number three, who went into the padding. North Greenville gets to keep the ball. Lob pass to Alexander from Reese. Alexander loses it and it's picked up by Miller. Miller to Stanley. Stanley has numbers and will put a shot in, misses it. And McCrary with the putback. 56-52. Now McElroy. Double teamed Stanley and Gwinchard. Parker to Alexander for two. Offensive charge called against North Greenville.
So Emmanuel was down by eight just a few moments ago. All of a sudden, they have the momentum. It's a brand new ball game here.
Micah Parker picks up his third. 17 fouls apiece for both teams. Control for the Lions, moves to the right side of the key. Tries to cut it back to the top, now takes a drive down the middle, puts up a shot, has a block. McElroy brings it down, and we'll get this Crusader offense calmed down and see what he can do. McElroy heads to the left side. Stanley on the defense, evades Stanley and runs into an Emmanuel defender, and another foul called. This one most likely going to be against McElroy. He does pick up his first.
Yeah, that did look to be a good call there. Looked like the defender had his feet set when he got hit. And a timeout's called.
Looks like North Greenville trying to burn some timeouts, get this team calmed down with 6:42 left. They're still up four, 56-52, but Emmanuel trying to chip away at that lead. Crusader offense struggling here of late, still clinging to a four-point lead, but Emmanuel trying to use another comeback, this time with their men's team, to sweep North Greenville here tonight. Miller's going to fire a deep three, no good, rebounded by Brown. Got hit in the face by Stanley. And I think of a stoppage in play, Brown hurting from that one as well. Did get whacked in the face, it would appear. No foul is called. And so Phillip Brown once again to the bench to get checked out. Chris Brown will take his place. North Greenville will get the inbound after play was blown dead.
Yeah, Brown's going to be sore after this game. He's going to have to get the ice ready.
Brown finds Alexander. Now Alexander finds Reeves. Reeves going to get it out of back court quickly. Reeves driving for the front court line. Does so. The half court line. Finally, the front court hands off to Davis. Davis looking for help. Uses McElroy as a pick. Now Davis drives back to the right side, hands off to Reeves. Reeves trying to drive underneath, and I think we got a foul called against Emmanuel. Foul goes up on the scoreboard against the Lions. And they call Luke Miller for his fourth. So foul trouble becoming a problem for the Lions. Luke Miller is up to four. And Spencer Reeves is at the free throw line for North Greenville. First free throw is good from Reeves. Second free throw also good from Reeves. Two for two that drive, 58-52, North Greenville leads. Stanley hands off right side to Burgess. Burgess drives, puts up a shot, and rims out. Stanley gets a rebound, and he gets it to go in. 58-54. See if Emmanuel, no full court press, no half court press. They'll shift back into their regular 2-3 defense. Davis, Christian Davis drives right, gets double teamed, trying to get out of it, hands off to McElroy. 5.5 left to play. McElroy driving left side, puts a shot up and in, good, and gets the foul as well. 60-54, and he's got a chance for one more. That foul on Patrick McCrary, picks up his first. Corval, 6'3", junior out of Kissimmee, Florida at the free throw line. Chance for three. Shot is up and no good, rimming out. Brown battles for the rebound. I think they're gonna get Brown for a foul. But now they call it on Emmanuel.
That's Emmanuel's 10th team foul, so they're in the Crusaders now in the double bonus.
Actually, that was on Phillip Brown, so that should be in North Greenville's foul category. I was wondering there for a minute. They put it in the Emmanuel's foul category. So now 9 team fouls apiece, and Phillip Brown picks up his first. And Jeremy Burgess to the free throw line at the other end. The shot is no good, rebounded by McElroy. McElroy gonna try to burn some clock, gotta make it to half court. And he'll creep across the line. He'll pass to Reeves. Reeves left side of the key. Driving out of a double team, top of the key, he'll line up a three, and then it's missed off the front of the rim. Now Stanley, back the other way, right side of the key, driving out, and he puts up a shot, rims in good. 60-56, under 5 minutes to play. Still one more media timeout to go, though. Reeves, driving forward for North Greenville, makes it in the front court, hands off to McElroy. McElroy driving to the far side. Looking for help, goes back to Reeves. Reeves goes to Brown underneath. Brown driving for the basket, spins, puts up a shot. Can't get it to go in. And we have a foul called. And looks like it's gonna go against Emmanuel. Now it's their 10th team foul, and it goes against Jeremy Burgess, who picks up his first. And the final media timeout, a 4:35 left to go in this second ball game of this doubleheader. North Greenville men lead the Emmanuel College men 60-56. Coming out of the last media timeout here in the second half, number 23, Chris Brown at the free throw line for North Greenville. First shot off the front of the rim, no good. Trying to get North Greenville a 5-point lead. The second one is good, 61-56. Got a 5-point lead for North Greenville. Now Stanley. Driving into an open lane, backward shot goes in, good. And now 61-58, Emmanuel back within three. McElroy heads to the far side. Stanley on defense for the Lions. McElroy drives underneath, puts up a shot, short, and brought down by Vest for the Lions. Quickly passes to Stanley. Stanley down the far court side. Passes to the left side and Burgess now to McCrary. Now back up front to Guinchard. Now McCrary back in control. Left side of the key. Brings it back to the top. Passing right side to Burgess. Burgess back up top to Guinchard. Now back to Stanley. Stanley moves to top of the key. Looks for an open hole. Moves right. Backs out. He's going to throw a three. Off the back of the rim. No good. Reeves on the rebound for North Greenville. 3.5 to go. Reeves in the front court for North Greenville trying to burn some clock. Moves left. Now brings it back right, slings it to Brown. Brown, top of the key. Looking for Parker. Now to Jake. Now to Alexander for two. 63-58, a little bit of breathing room for North Greenville. Stanley, left side and Burgess. Burgess back to McCrary. Now right side Stanley. Stanley hands off to Guinchard. Guinchard back out to Burgess for three. Is short, no good. Rebound is tipped and brought down by Guinchard. Burgess drives in for two. And he'll have to sling it back out to Guinchard. Now Stanley, right side of the key, moves further right. Brown on defense, puts up a pop shot in and good. 63-60. Approaching 2.5 to play. McElroy in the front court for North Greenville. On the right side of the key. Double team passes out to Brown. Brown drives underneath. Hands off to Alexander, who tries again for another shot. And short. Tipped up and in. Good.
Emmanuel bench very upset about that. They wanted a foul. Or excuse me, a walk.
Not sure who called that timeout, but time has been stopped. With 2:14 left, North Greenville up 65-60. 2:14 left to go in the ball game. North Greenville up 5, coming out of the Emmanuel timeout. Trying to get their team settled down with Stanley driving in from the right side. Puts up a shot, can't get it to go. Reeves, battle for the rebound with North Greenville. Double team, dribbles, passes back to Brown. Brown back to Reeves, got to get out of backcourt. Reeves trying to get into front court. Finally gets across the half court line. Nice spin move there. Reeves has a pass intended for Alexander. Go in and out of his hands and back to Emmanuel with under 2 to play. Now Stanley. Top of the key for the Lions. Heads to the right side. Alexander on the defense. Stanley drives in, puts up a shot. Good for 2. 65-62. Now quick pass down to Alexander. Down to Phillip Brown, right side of the key.
Emmanuel wanted another walk.
Brown is tied up, and we have a timeout called.
Yeah, timeout taken by North Greenville that time.
Minute 32, 65-62. North Greenville up 3 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. North Greenville trying to even the series today with Emmanuel. North Greenville women lost today to the Emmanuel women. As the inbound pass is tipped and Alexander brings it down for North Greenville. Now Emmanuel steals it and they'll lose it out of bounds.
Crusaders very fortunate to be able to hold on to that ball. Almost had a big turnover there.
Minute 29 left to work with, up 3. McRoy trying to find the inbound. Will sling it to Phillip Brown. And Phillip Brown in the backcourt has the ball stolen by number 11. Penneret gets it in for 2. North Greenville all of a sudden in a lot of trouble.
And here comes the pressure by Emmanuel.
McRoy being pressured by Stanley. McRoy down the near court side. Stanley backs out of it. McRoy near court side driving that way. Will sling it cross court for Alexander, puts it in for 2! Under a minute to go, North Greenville up 3. Stanley right side of the key, drives in for the basket, can't get it in, tip is in and good by Vess.
There was a lot of contact on that play, but the officials decided to let it go. And Emmanuel once again down by just 1 point. What a game this has become.
Emmanuel quick to use another timeout. 51.4 left.
Seen two fantastic basketball games that looked like they were pretty one-sided, especially in the first half. The women, North Greenville went up early, and Emmanuel just really played a great second half, and now the men seem to be doing the same thing. Just fantastic basketball. This is the first home game for the men's basketball team, and boy, what a game it's been.
See what strategy Emmanuel elects to go with.
Gray and I were just talking during the break. We're with media timeouts, it can get pretty confusing. So our timeout count that you see under the team names, it's not official. It's what we believe are the number of timeouts left for each team.
Got to get out of backcourt. McRoy into front court. 36 seconds and rolling. McRoy near side. Heads back to the top of the key. Moves left, looking for some help. McRoy backs out of it. Gets double teamed, trying to find Reeves, can't find Reeves. Now he'll finally. Well, time is called.
And once again, Emmanuel wanted another walk, and they did not get it.
I think North Greenville lucky to get, if that was a North Greenville timeout, very lucky to get that one.
Definitely.
21.3 seconds, now 5 on the shot clock. Still a 1-point lead for NGU.
Reminder that our next broadcast is next Saturday, December 6th. It's women's and men's basketball. The women will be playing Allen University at 6 o'clock p.m., and then the men will play Truett McConnell College. It says 7:30, but I'm guessing it'll start a little bit later than that. So we certainly hope you join us then. But still have to finish this one.
Spencer Reeves will inbound for North Greenville. He finds Phillip Brown. Hands back off to Reeves. He's going to fire a deep three. It rims out. 16 seconds left. Emmanuel comes down with it. Stanley down the other way. Drives for the basket. Slings it up. And North Greenville basketball. Offensive foul against the Lions.
That was a close one. Looking at the replay.
You could have called it travel. It looks like he took more than 2 steps. North Greenville, 10.6 seconds. Trying to hold on.
You can bet these are going to be a long 10.6 seconds. If North Greenville gets the ball, you know Emmanuel's going to foul as quickly as possible. This game nowhere even close to being over.
Micah Parker will be the inbounder. Got to get it in. He finds Spencer Reeves, and there's the foul. 9.2 left. And Spencer Reeves, not particularly sure if he's the guy you want to be fouling.
Reeves comes into this game 5 for 7, and that's right, he had the 3 free throws with being fouled on the 3-point attempt, made all of them. So is now 8 for 11.
And now makes that one.
9 for 12.
And Emmanuel taking another timeout, still one more free throw. It's still going to be a one-possession game either way with 9.2 left.
And again, just want to remind everybody one more time that the timeout bar that we have on our scoreboard is unofficial. We're not sure exactly how many timeouts are left. We do follow, you know, who's taken which timeout, but with the media timeouts being included, it can get confusing. So just letting you know right now.
No live stats have been brought up here either.
Yeah, the live stats were down for quite a while. They are now working, but unfortunately there are no timeout counts on there either. So, yeah, just timeouts in college basketball can certainly get confusing. But what a game it's been. North Greenville still shooting over 50% in field goal percentage, 52%, 26 for 50. Emmanuel 28 out of 68, so a lot of shot attempts, 41.2%. And it could come down to this. It could come down to Emmanuel attempting a last second three-pointer to tie the game if this free throw is made. Emmanuel 4 for 19 in three-point field goals. That's just 21.1%. And they came into this game with a 35.1 three-point percentage. So
both teams are going to be in the double bonus. North Greenville's got 9 team fouls, and Emmanuel has 10. That last foul was on number 33. Michael Stanley picks up his second. The free throw from Reeves is good. So it is a three-point ball game, 9.2 to work with, 69-66. So it might come down to one possession for Emmanuel. We might need overtime. Inbounded to Stanley. Stanley. Cross half court. Bird is going to fire a deep three. It's missed. Reeves trying to get the inbound, and he steps out. Ooh. It's going to be Emmanuel Ball with 0.8 of a second left.
They're calling another timeout. What an opening home game for the Crusaders, Gray.
You got 0.8 of a second left. That's about enough time for a pitch in or shoot.
Yep. And you can bet that's what North Greenville's going over right now, just telling their players not to get an open shot off, and possibly just as importantly, don't foul. The live stats showing that it's a final score, but that is not the case here.
Negative.
It is not over yet.
Jeremy Burgess, number one, will be the inbounder for Emmanuel. Burgess is going to sling it to Miller. He'll fire a three. It's no good. Off
wow.
the rim. Missed it by literally that much.
Well, the live stats turned out to be right, but wow. What a game. And what, you know, I know that Emmanuel is disappointed, but what a comeback by them. I mean, they were down by as much as, I believe, 8 points here in the second half. So a fantastic job by them. Yeah, they were down by 8 points with 17-19 remaining in the second half. I think a lot of us were starting to think, you know, this game is starting to get away from Emmanuel, but they did a nice job of coming back and making it a ball game. So great game to open up the North Greenville, well, North Greenville's first home game here at Hayes Gymnasium.
So the North Greenville men's team wins 69-66 over Emmanuel College. Thank you for joining us tonight, Grace Sello and Alan Cahaley on the call tonight. Hope to see you, if not here from Hayes Gymnasium. Please join us on here on Ustream next two Saturdays from now, actually December the 6th, as Crusader basketball team back in action here on the North Greenville Sports Network. The women fall 71-66. The men win 69-66 over Emmanuel College. We'll go ahead and sign off. See you a couple Saturdays from now on December the 6th.